Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of God, who is the most merciful, the beneficent. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I have changed my speech. It was on the message and the mission of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. I'm very happy that Gordon has also touched upon the recent events. And in light of the recent events, I feel it's important that I share my views with all of you. Being the president of UK Islamic Mission, so that everyone understands clearly what is the stance of the Muslims in the UK. The events in France, the very horrible events in France, and again we heard in Belgium as well, that once again these events have brought Islam, they have brought the Muslims, and they have brought the character of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, into global focus, however in a very negative way. Since 9/11, there has been only a week in which we don't hear something negative about Islam and the Muslim community. Hardly any week where, you know, it is not discussed, and every effort we feel sometimes through the media is being made to link Islam directly with killing, with murder, with violence, and with terrorism. And it is in light of, because of these things, it is widespread perceptions that the Islamic Sharia is barbaric, Muslims are perceived as backward people, primitive, and people who are not able to adapt themselves and live in a civilized modern world. Muslims are seen with suspicion, and there are fears that some of them will be harboring terrorists in their houses. The debate about Islam and its link with terrorism has increased support for the far right in UK and across Europe. And unfortunately, this is leading to more suspicion and more division in our pluralistic, multicultural societies. However, for every terrorist action which has taken place, which has involved a so-called Muslim, all mainstream Muslim scholars and imams, all mainstream organizations and groups, all mosques across the whole of UK, Europe, and the USA, and all over the world, great Islamic universities and institutions, they have all come out with one voice, and they have strongly condemned these horrible actions. And they have come out saying that Islam has got nothing whatsoever to do with violence and with terrorism. Even in a war situation, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, has said that when you are fighting in a war, in the battlefield, do not raise your swords against the elderly, against women and children. Do not destroy people's houses and property. Do not burn the fields. Do not kill cattle, but only fight against those who fight against you. During the 23 years of his work in Makkah and in Medina in Saudi Arabia, we find that he was persecuted almost every day by his people. He was abused and he was wronged, and every attempt was made to kill him many times. For instance, he went to a city called Taif. There he gave the message of God to them. And instead of welcoming him and listening to his message, they sent thugs. And they stoned him so much that blood was coming from every part of his body. And people asked him to pray to destroy these people. But he lifted his hands and he said, God did not send me to curse people. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He sent me as a mercy. He lifted up his hands and said, oh God, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Maybe their future generations will accept the right guidance. There is a saying, he was talking to one of his close companions, Hazrat Anas, and he said, oh son, if you can sleep at night, if you are able to pass the morning and the evening without harboring any ill feelings against any human being, then do so. Oh my son, this is my sunnah, this is my way, this is my guidance. And whoever revives my way, that he loves me and he will be with me in paradise. Do not sleep at night and wake up in the morning without any ill feeling about any human being. This is the mercy of a merciful Prophet. How can he even think about killing human beings? The Prophet ﷺ, when he went to Medina, he made a peace treaty with the people in Medina, and they were mainly Jewish community. He said, we will protect the Jewish community and we will try to live in peace. This is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And I will just read out one quote here. There was some tension between some new Muslims and between the Christians who lived in Sinai, the Christians living as monks there in 628 CE. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ heard about this. Immediately he sent a letter, and that's called the Charter of Privileges with the monks of St. Catherine Monastery in Mount Sinai. And this letter, it included the following. He said, this is a message from Muhammad ibn Abdullah, a covenant to those who are Christians, near and far. We are with our fellow Christians. Verily, I and my followers will defend them, because Christians are my citizens. And by Allah, I hold against anything that displeases them. There will be no compulsion on the Christians. Neither are their judges to be removed from their jobs, nor their monks from their monasteries. No one should destroy their houses, or damage them, or take anything from their houses. Should anyone take anything from a Christian by force or by injustice, he would spoil God's covenant and disobey his Prophet. Verily, Christians are my allies and have my secure charter against all that they hate. No one is to force them to travel or to oblige them to fight. The Muslims are there to defend them. If a female Christian marries a Muslim, it is not to take place without her approval, and she should not be prevented from visiting the church to pray. This is the charter of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he was at the height of power. He developed a pluralistic society where no man, woman, or child was wrong, and all human beings who live under Islam, they live under peace and justice. The kind of people he produced, just one example, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the second Khalifa of Islam. By his time, Islam had spread right into China, into Europe, right into Africa, and up to Morocco. He used to cry every day. He said, Allah will question me, God will question me on the day of judgment, even if a dog dies during my rule, and I did not do anything about it. This is what Islam teaches. He taught that the best among you are those who are best to their wives. Ladies and gentlemen, I have four daughters. I have never discriminated between them and my son, because Muhammad, peace be upon him, has taught me to do this. He said, anyone who has two daughters and treats them with dignity, respect, and educates them and trains them, gives them the best training, that person and me will be like this in Jannah. Then we hear all these rumors. That Islam mistreats women, Islam does this. I cannot relate to that kind of Islam. Anybody who takes a serious study of Islam, they will see a different Islam than what is presented day and night. However, in line with his teachings, you know, he did not react against those who insulted him. So in regarding the cartoons, we see what happened in France. How should Muslims behave and react? According to the teaching of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we are supposed to pray for people who insult Islam and insult the Muslims. We are supposed to care for them, and we are supposed to open up doors for dialogue and understanding. And this is exactly what we, the UK Islam Mission, and all the Muslims here in the UK and in Europe, what we want. I invite all fellow non-Muslims sitting here today to come forward and to do their independent study of Islam and to study the life of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and then judge for themselves. Whoever has taken a serious study, their views have been radically changed. Whether this man should be demonized, whether this man should be insulted, or whether this man should be brave and his teaching should be followed. I invite all councillors sitting here, all the MPs, all the heads of communities and different organizations to come together, to work together, so that we can build understanding in our multicultural society, so that we can promote peace in our society and justice, and let us all join hands and work to uproot all forms of terrorism from amidst ourselves, be these terrorist activities from individuals or be they from our governments. We will all work together to fight against all forms of wrong so that no man, woman or child is wrong, so that together we work to make Britain into Great Britain again. This is our vision, this is our dream, and we want to help each of you. Prophet Muhammad worked, as you have heard previously from the previous speaker, the warring tribes, he made them into one single brotherhood. Black and white, he made them stand shoulder to shoulder. Five times a day, go to any mosque, you will see no discrimination between the people. Women, girls who were buried alive, they were people start to pray for girls so that on the day of judgment, they will get dignity and honor. This is the man called Muhammad. His message has been clearly, he gave us a unique concept of God, a unique concept of man, and a unique concept of how to use power. Regarding God, he said, La ilaha illallah. Let there be no God but the one God. Reject every false God. Do not take your desires and your ego as your God. Do not take the culture of your society as your God. Do not take religious and political leaders as your God. Worship that one God and follow his own, follow his guidance alone. All these other gods will make you fight and divide you so that they can dominate and exploit you. Turn to that one God. We all believe in one God and we feel we can unite on this concept. He gave a new concept of man. Man is not created from apes, but created in a very dignified, special way. Man is the Khalifa, the vicegerent of God. That means we should be stewards. We are not gods or the masters and the lords of this earth, but we are vicegerents of the master and the lord. We are stewards. We are responsible for our actions in this day, in this world. We are stewards of animals and the nature and of our societies. We have to work for peace and justice and dignity. This is man called Muhammad. And finally, he gave us a new framework how to use power. Anybody in authority or in power does not have the right to go and plunder and loot the earth and violate international law and go and terrorize countries after countries to dominate, to impose their wills. Muhammad said, power must be used within a moral and just framework. Stand up for justice, even if it's against yourself, against your parents, against the rich or the poor. All people are equal before the law, and justice must be done. This is what Muhammad, peace be upon him, has taught us. A time came when the Khalifa is standing and a woman stands up and said, we will not listen to you until you give answer to this question. There was accountability to those in power. There was a shura concept, discussion with everyone, so that people participated in sharing power. This is the new civilization which Muhammad, peace be upon him, laid the scene. And that civilization enlightened and illumined the world for over 1,000 years. It is very unfortunate today that Muslims themselves have gone far from Islam. They have confused Islam with their cultural heritage. And this is why we are seeing some of the things which are happening in our community. I invite Muslims to come back to the Quran and to the way of the Prophet. And I encourage non-Muslims sitting here, please, for the sake of better society, let us try to understand each other. If our councillors and MPs do not want to take this leadership, we in the UK Islamic Mission want to take this leadership. We will lead our people and come to our mosques, Look at what we are doing. Let us open doors for dialogue. Let us build bridges. Let us try to understand each other so that we can better work together for a better society. I pray that we are able to do this and work for a peaceful and better society. Thank you very much for listening.